glad you're here because we're about to sing a song. Now, I'm going to sing, and Linda's going to show us how to talk with our hands.
Oh, boy, this sounds great.
You ready? Talk with your hands. Here's how they go. If you want to say hello,
hello.
Talk with your hands. Watch with your eyes and learn to say surprise. Talk with your hands. Here's what you do to tell someone I love you.
I love you.
Talk with your hands. Let's say it once again. Hello. Surprise. I love you.
Oh, wow.
Monster time. Hey, how do you sign? It's monster time.
Count Von Count. Which number will be the number of the day today? Well, let's find out. Warm up.
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
When will we get there?
9, 10, 11, 13.
Not yet.
14, 15, 16.
We must go even higher. 17, 18, 19.
Today's number is me.
Number 19. Let's get it. Yes, 19.
Surprise, Emily.
Pop for Papa! Come on! Oh, hello there, Big Bird.
Hi, Grover.
Hi, Grover.
Hello.
Oh, boy. Popcorn.
Yes, popcorn. I, Grover, have decided to become a purveyor of popcorn. And I have everything perfectly planned.
That's good.
See? See, I have my cute little popcorn popper thingy here, and lots of popcorn. And over here, I have small boxes and large boxes. Oh, and who can forget the sign?
Oh, yeah, it says popcorn.
Mm-hmm.
Gee, this is really great, Grover. A popcorn stand right here on Sesame Street. I love popcorn almost as much as I love birdseed.
I love popcorn, too.
I just have one teensy little problem.
Oh, what's that, Grover?
The popcorn will not pop! The little baby kernels, they just sit there and the popper not popping! Oh, what am I going to do? Oh!
Did you turn on the popper?
Turn on the popper?
Yeah, you know, that's it, isn't it, Emily? The popcorn won't pop unless you turn on the popper, you know.
Ah, silly me. Yes, of course, I will just go turn it on right now. Yes, I will just turn on the popper somehow.
I think you press this little button.
Hmm?
Right here.
Oh, and what a cute little button it is. Yes.
Ah-ha.
There.
Gee, soon we're going to have fresh popcorn.
Mm-hmm.
Gee, I don't hear any corn popping.
Well, of course not! Ah, I just remembered the cardinal rule of the popcorn business.
What's that?
We have to count to 20.
Count to 20?
Why?
What else would you do while you wait for corn to pop? Ready?
Sure. Hey, you can count with us, okay?
Yeah, you betcha! Here we go!
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11.
12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20!
Hey, Grover!
Woo! We did it!
Grover, I hear popcorn popping.
Hmm? Oh, is that what that sound is? Oh!
Boy, look at all that popcorn falling.
So what'll it be, small or large?
I'll take it small, please.
Coming right up! One small box of popcorn, and for helping me, it is on the house.
Thanks, Grover. Bye.
You're welcome.
See you later, Emily.
Bye-bye, Emily. Bye-bye. Enjoy. Okay, Big Bird, what will it be for you?
Well, I'll have the same, please.
Right away, sir.
Popcorn on Sesame Street.
Popcorn! Mr. large boxes?
No, but I think I'll take a small box. Thanks.
Small? No. I insist you take more, Ernie. You are growing boy.
Ooh.
And this popcorn popper turns up popcorn faster than a bird with the machine gun popper.
I guess you do have a problem there, Grover.
Oh, if only there were two of me. I'd send one of me out to look for more customers.
Too bad there aren't two of you, Grover. Hey, wait a minute. I can go tell people that you're here.
You would do that for me?
Sure, you just keep filling those boxes. I'll go let people know you're here. I'll spread the word. Hey, you hawkers, hold up there.
Thank you, Ernie. Oh, thank goodness. I'm going to get some more customers. A moment too soon. Popcorn!
Hey, you hawkers! You want some popcorn? Right over there.
Excuse me?
Yep.
Did you say popcorn?
Sure did. Follow those hawkers.
We love popcorn!
Yeah. I know you would. Hey, Lulu, did you hear about Grover's popcorn stand?
Really? A popcorn stand?
Yeah, so don't you want to go get some?
I don't eat popcorn.
What? No?
No, I'm a pretzel person. Pretzels are the yummiest, crispiest, most wonderful snack that ever was. I love the way they're all bendy and pretzely.
Yeah, well, I like pretzels, too.
I thought you liked popcorn.
Well, I like both.
Both? You like both?
Well, sure, I like all kinds of snacks. You know, like popcorn and pretzels and peanuts and raisins.
Yeah, I like one kind. Hmm? Pretzels. Boy, I wish I had a pretzel now.
Well, Lulu, did you ever taste popcorn?
Nope.
Well, then how do you know you don't like it?
Because it's not a pretzel.
Well, yeah, but Grover really needs customers, and besides, this is really good stuff.
They seem to like it.
Yep.
You know, maybe I'll just take a teeny tiny bite.
Okay. Sure.
Let me just... Let me try some more. I'm still not sure.
Gee, this is really turning into quite some taste test here.
Here you go.
Gee, I guess you like it, huh?
No, not really. I like pretzels. I think I'll go get one. See you, Ernie.
Yeah, I think I'd like a pretzel, too. Gee, I wonder if Grover would consider opening a pretzel stand. Hey, wait up, you pig.
Popcorn! Wow! I saw a great movie last night on TV. What's that? Yeah, I think we better. Grover!
Popcorn!
Are you all right, Grover?
I am fine, Bob. Except for this little popcorn problem. My popcorn popper keeps popping and popping, and I keep scooping and scooping, but I just cannot keep up. Ernie has been nice enough to send lots of customers my way, but it is no good. There is nothing left to do. See what I mean?
Grover, there is one thing that you can do.
No, believe me, the best minds on Sesame Street, my mind and Ernie's, have been working on this problem, and it is impossible to solve.
Right, Grover. Just turn off the popper.
Turn off the popper.
Thank you. I found some more popcorn lovers, Grover. Come on, chicken. Looks like you'll need to pop some more corn, Grover.
Oh, no. Grover has popped his last corn. I am Who put it simple? Pop. What is it, Ernie?
You know, Bert, I just remembered. I didn't put away all my toys. I left a big mess in the other room. Do you think I should get up and clean that stuff up now?
Well, Ernie, it's time to go to sleep now. You can do that in the morning.
Yeah. It's pretty messy in there, Bert.
Well, Ernie, you're just a little messy. I've learned that. I'm used to it. Let's go to sleep.
You know, Bert, you're a real friend. I'm messy, and you don't like it messy. But because I'm your friend, you don't mind too much if I'm messy.
Well, not too much, Ernie. Let's just go to sleep.
But that's what a friend is, Bert. I mean, not minding too much because you like someone. That's a friend, Bert. A pal. Not minding. That's what friends are for.
I am messy.
Really messy.
But you don't mind if I am messy. If I'm messy, you don't mind it. That's what friends are for. You like pigeons?
I love them.
Well, I don't mind if you like pigeons. If you like them, I don't mind it. That's what friends are for. Friends help you put away your toys.
Help? I do it alone mostly, Ernie.
Do-do-do-do, friends. Don't mind if you make a little noise.
A little noise? Like what?
Like this, Bert. You didn't mind that, did you, Bert, old pal?
Not much. Ernie, I'm tired. I'm really tired.
You're tired, Bert. Well, that's okay, old buddy. You see, I don't mind if you're tired, because you're my friend. You can be tired if you want to.
You are tired? Really tired? Well, I don't mind if you are tired. If you're tired, I don't mind it. That's what friends are for.
I'm gonna sleep anyway.
Friends always lend a helping hand. The kind of friends that understand, and they don't mind it.
Right, Bert? Bert? He's sleeping. Well, I don't mind if he's sleeping, because he's my friend, because that's what friends are for. Bert, it's okay if you're sleeping, Bert. I don't mind, Bert. It's okay.
What is okay?
You are sleeping. Really sleeping, but I don't mind if you are sleeping.
Sleeping?
If you're sleeping, I don't mind it. That's what friends are for. That's what friends scooby-doo. That's what friends dee-dee-dee-dee.
I'm gonna go sleep in the kitchen.
Friends skee-dee-bee-dum. That's what friends scooby-doo. That's what friends are for.
Right, Bert? Bert? I guess he's going to sleep in the kitchen again. Well, if he wants to sleep in the kitchen, that's okay with me, because he's my friend.
Nom, 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 so delicious. Nom, nom. Oh, hi. Ha, ha, ha. Me just looking at what appeared to be letter I. Cookie. Yeah. But me better make sure, yeah. Does it sound like letter I? Me listen. Yeah. As in igloo. Yeah, me listen again. I, yeah. That also sound of letter I, like in icing. Oh, icing. Oh, yeah, me love cookie with icing. Nah, nah, nah. What me doing? Me no can eat letter of day cookie. What me thinking? Oh, what me do? Oh, icing so delicious. Nah, nah, nah. Me got it. Me no, ha, ha, ha. Me no eat cookie. Me just eat icing. Ha, ha. Me try that. matter of day anymore. Well, no reason not to eat cookie! Bye-bye. Where we go? Oh,
we all live in a capital I, in the middle of the desert, in the center of the sky. And all day long we polish on the eye to keep it clean and shiny so it brightens up the sky. Rubbing it here and scrubbing it there, polishing the eye so high in the air. As we work, we sing a lively tune. Great to be so happy on a busy afternoon. And when we're through with the day's only chore, we go into the eye and we close the door. Capital I, capital I, capital I, capital I.
La la la, la 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 la, Elmo's world. La 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 la, la 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 la, Elmo's world. His crayon too. That's Elmo's world.
Welcome to Elmo's world. Elmo's so happy to see you. Oh, and so is Dorothy. Say hello, Dorothy. Oh, guess what Elmo's thinking about today?
Today's feature, the girl who loved to sleep. Oh. Once upon a time, there was a girl who loved to sleep.
I love to sleep.
One night, she fell asleep and dreamed that she was flying high up in the sky.
Whee!
But instead of clouds in the sky, there were ice cream cones, all flavors.
Wow!
And her cat, Rocket, was riding on a motorcycle.
Rocket!
And she woke up.
Rocket, what a racket. Purring in my ear. Now go to sleep.
She went back to sleep and dreamed that she was sliding down a big slide. Landed in a big sea of bubbles.
Wow!
And her cat Rocket floated by on a bubble. He had a big mustache.
Rocket?
Then, all of a sudden, she had a big mustache.
Wow!
It tickled her, and she woke up.
Rocket, your tail. Now go to sleep.
So she fell asleep again and dreamed her cat Rocket was chasing a mouse.
Hey, that's not my dream. That's Rocket's dream.
Anyway, the girl and her cat dreamed happily ever after. The end.
Open up, please. Thank you. Look! Wow!
How about talking to a bed? I mean, I'm where it all happens.
You tell him, Betty boy.
Wow! A bed and pillow.
Don't forget the covers on top. And me, the mattress underneath.
You tell him, Betty boy.
Warm and comfy.
Uh-huh. 40 winks with me, and you'll be feeling good as new.
Huh?
Sleep. It helps you stay healthy and gives you energy.
You tell him, Betty boy.
Wow.
Nighttime, daytime, anytime's a good time to hit the sack.
Could you keep it down, please? I got someone napping here.
Oh, sorry.
Not all birds sleep in nests, you know. Flamingos sleep standing on one leg.
Dorothy's imagining Elmo as a flamingo. Oh, sleeping on one leg.
And bats sleep hanging upside down.
Elmo needs to get a grip.
Thank you.